I don't know what TikTok video, TikTok trend, live stream I missed, but over the past couple of days, everyone has been talking about this Wplace.live thing. If you look at the Google Trends, it looks a little bit like this. And I was browsing around, and I found this one right here. I found me a bit of Linux somewhere between, I don't know, what is this, a little bit north of Adelaide. Also, here's some other funny Australian ones because haha, funny Australian place names. And from what I can tell, this has been around since somewhere late July, but people didn't know it existed up until maybe 3, 4, 5 days ago. And when people found out about it, it really did pop off. It's basically a larger take on Reddit's r/place. A canvas where individuals can place one pixel at a time and then draw various things they want to draw, either collaborate with each other or terrorize each other and destroy other people's stuff. So you start seeing turf wars start, you start seeing flags being drawn and flags encroaching on other flags, and it can become a big mess. And by larger take, I mean you have the entire world to draw on. Here we are just looking at a tiny bit of Australia, but you can draw on every single country. I don't know, let's take Brazil, because Brazil mentioned. And each of these little squares here, you can draw something on. Now, as you can see, it is offline, and they've been having a number of technical challenges recently. That's what I want to talk about today. First, though, a bit of a side tangent. Stop pointing to your house. Stop writing your phone number. There were people doing this. Just basic cybersecurity practice, right? Draw funny things, whatever you want to draw. Don't put like your phone number. Stop it. Stop doing that. I don't know why for so many, basic safety was just thrown entirely out the window here. I don't remember people doing this on r/place, but I guess if you can see, ooh, that's my house, that's my house, that's my house. I want everybody to know that's my house. Don't do that. Stop it. Stop doing that. Anyway, what I want to talk about is the tech that is powering this. As you can probably guess, it is getting map data from OpenStreetMap. Now, this is a basically community-driven effort to put maps together. It's been around for about 21 years, and it is surprisingly good. Now, obviously, the applications that make use of OpenStreetMaps are never going to be as good as something like Google Maps, where it collects a lot of your data. They have giant server farms that can do routing for you. But purely on showing map data, it is really, really good. And for something like this, where you just need to know where things are, you need to know where countries are, streets are, knowing where every individual business is that is entirely up to date, not really relevant to what the goal here is. However, it has been shown, demonstrated, maybe coincidences, but when you have enough of them in a row, it stops looking like a coincidence, where changes in OpenStreetMap does influence things like Google Maps, even though they've never publicly stated it, even though it's kind of walking the fine line of the license. There's been things demonstrated in the past where it seems like they probably at least acknowledge it's around. But this is just the map data. The thing that is providing it in a useful form, this is a service known as OpenFreeMap. This is all self-hostable, but there is a public instance that you can go and use. And that public instance is the reason why we're in this situation right here. Why we're in a situation where it went down for a while, it's still kind of down, and yeah, there's some fun based around it. So here is a post from the author of OpenFreeMap and the person who was running the public instance. I was about to post about how nice the last 10 months of OpenFreeMap have been. The architecture has really proven itself to be great. Cloudflare has agreed to sponsor the bandwidth. Hetzner servers are super stable as always. Serving tiles from Butterfest proved to be a great choice. Nginx is amazing and life is good. And then, out of nowhere, I'm getting reports that some tiles are not loading, which normally means tile generation bugs, but not this time. I look at the Nginx logs and see this. Too many files open. This is weird. I've never seen anything like this. I check nload and it shows huge traffic. I log into Cloudflare and I see this for the past 24 hours. 3.12 billion requests, 215 terabytes of data from 70 kilobyte files. In other words, a lot of data and a lot of traffic, and the fact that it was even working to begin with, genuinely impressive. This much traffic would have cost over $6 million per month on MapTiler and double that on Mapbox. So MapTiler and Mapbox are basically other map services you can use. And yeah, this would have cost a lot for Wplace to run if it wasn't making use of a free public instance. As of the time of writing, it was especially spiking in the last 15 minutes, seeing 30 million requests. 30 million requests in a 5-minute span. This is 100,000 per second. Now, it's totally fine if you have a service that is massive that is dealing with that amount of traffic. But going from nothing even remotely close to that to 100,000 per second, you're gonna think, hey, maybe something is wrong here. Maybe something is maybe, I don't know, hitting this a little bit harder than it should be. Maybe there's a new service that is integrating with this that's doing something crazy. And that's exactly what was happening, because this was right in the center of Wplace.live just massively exploding, just popping off, everybody finding out about it. And this free instance basically having to deal with it without actually knowing what was going on at this point. They had no idea that this thing even existed. And honestly, I respect these initial thoughts. Wow, I'm surprised the only bug I've heard about is some missing files. I mean, the server still seems to work. Somehow those empty tiles got cached by Cloudflare, but other than that, it still worked. 96% of the requests were 200 okay, and only 3.6% were 206 partial content. Somehow, it was all just working. And at this point, they didn't know why this was even happening to begin with, but very quickly found out when the entire internet was talking about something related to mapping. So what else could it possibly be? And of course, that is Wplace.live. I don't know what it is, but the internet seems to be crazy about it. One thing is for sure, the traffic it generates is out of this world. Yeah. Yeah, especially when it just comes pretty much out of nowhere. Whilst Wplace does have a lot of legitimate users, it became an internet sensation basically overnight. There are still too many requests being made to the mapping service itself. There will be a lot of people making use of Wplace, but this seems a little bit high. If you're sitting in a singular area and you're drawing a really complex image, you're not going to be constantly requesting map data. That's going to be something handled directly on the Wplace website. So the theory is that a lot of these images are being drawn with scripts. Now, this is technically not following the rules. It is a form of botting. However, you know, rules only exist if there is moderation for those rules. So, you know, nice idea and interesting project. Next time, please contact me before. Neil.fun did the same thing before launching Internet Road Trip. So, where are they right now? They're in Quebec, Canada. They are in a lake currently, or a river. How did this happen? Okay, so... Internet road trip is basically you're on a road trip, and then people can vote which direction they want to go down. Somehow they wound up in a river. I didn't even know this was possible, so... Somehow this has happened, but this is still going, and this is something that the author of OpenFreeMap is also powering and is well aware is happening. And they even asked if the traffic would be okay, and then even decided to sponsor OpenFreeMap with an amount that more than covers their bandwidth usage. So here's the reason why we have some problems on Wplace. I had to create my first ever Cloudflare rule as a single user. You broke the service for everyone and basically had to block Wplace.live. Now, I've seen some people say, oh, there's no way you could have known beforehand this was going to go viral. And yes, you can't be certain this is going to happen. But this is prime viral material, right? Look at every single Reddit r/place. It becomes an internet sensation for whatever length of time it goes for. And even if you're not sure how popular it's going to be, you definitely could let the owner of this instance know that, hey, maybe something is gonna happen here. Just keep an eye out for this and sort of open a line of conversation there. As the sole person running OpenFreeMap, I'm incredibly proud of these two numbers. First, that my architecture hit a 99.4% CDN cache rate, which is fantastic for a service with weekly data updates. And second, that my own server successfully handled the remaining 1,000 requests per second. So the main reason this even worked to begin with is Cloudflare was doing a lot of the heavy lifting here, right? Like, without Cloudflare here, this would have been dead within a minute. Probably even less, a couple of seconds. But this is not the end. So they reached out to the Wplace author. He said they grew to 2 million users in a few days out of the blue, so I totally understand them not being prepared for this kind of traffic. By the way, I'm amazed that their main architecture is holding up. Honestly, I am as well. The fact that people are still checking this website to see if it's working and constantly pinging it, and it's still here, it's still working. Very impressive. Or especially so when it was at its peak, where everybody was trying to actually draw things, the fact that it was working then? You've done something good there. I offered to help them set up a self-hosted OpenFreeMap instance, which is the perfect fit for such use cases. They get the service for free, the public instance doesn't get the load, and everyone is happy. Also, if you don't believe there is a lot of people doing scripting, this right here is the second search result under the official website. Wplace.live tools scripts complete introduction. Now, this might be a malware website and very likely is a malware website, but people are looking for scripts. People are looking for ways to abuse this. And it's a website where you place pixels by clicking something. Not exactly a Herculean task to script. So, for the future, I need to implement bandwidth limiting by referrer. I'm looking into how to do this on Cloudflare. Nothing changes in the service. Everything will stay free and without registration. But every referrer will be limited to a very high number, like 100 million requests per 24 hours or something similar. For native apps, I'll probably ask them to add a custom header identifying their app. I'll need to improve my server config to fix those empty tiles. Even though I'm not expecting a load like this in the future, I think I found the culprit in the config that was causing the missing tiles. So, if you want to support a project that somehow managed to survive all of these requests, you can go and support the OpenFreeMap project, even though it is not going to be the thing that's actually powering Wplace anymore. It's going to be running their own instance of OpenFreeMap, which is the thing that probably should have been done from the start. It's still going to power it. It's still going to help the development of the project. And hey, maybe when someone else comes along, it'll be able to survive, you know, even more requests. So when Wplace.live gets everything sorted again, we'll see what happens. We'll see if things stay popular. And if it happens quick enough, I do expect that to happen. If it takes too long, well, people will move on to the next thing, the next fun internet trend. But we'll see. Right now, it's like in a weird state, But we'll see. So, hopefully you learned something about this thing. And if you didn't know about Wplace, now you do. Check it out. Maybe by the time this video comes out, it'll all be working again. Probably not, but we will see. So, if you liked the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Ali Barapay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and my place is the Wplace. Money, then I don't accept.